Hey everybody, this is Mike McFrong, the ADR director and line producer of One Piece, and I have another Straw Hat pirate with me today. For those watching, who are you and who do you play?
My name is Brina Palencia, and I play Tony Chopper.
Excellent. What are your thoughts about Tony Chopper? What are your thoughts on the character?
That he's possibly the most adorable character in all of anime.
Most adorable?
One of them, at least.
Yeah.
I think he's in, like, the top five, at the very least.
Well, besides the obvious qualities, or even just, including the obvious qualities, what makes Chopper so adorable to you? What makes you have this opinion?
Well, just his character design is definitely adorable, but I also love how naive he is, and I love how just, how much he just loves everyone that is his friend and how much he wants everyone to be his friend and how much he's willing to sacrifice for his friends. I think it's really sweet.
There, good. I'm sure glad this thing was still here. Now, if anything really bad happens, the Sky Knight will come save me. But I can only blow it as a last resort. Hear that? Anyone wants to take this ship?
Just one. Surely you're not the only sacrifice I get to kill.
Do you recall anything about the initial casting process and the recording process way back in the days, in the dark ages of 2007?
Yeah, definitely. To this day, it's still the most intense audition process I've ever had to go through for, voice acting. And I can't even remember how many rounds there were. I think I was in three rounds. Normally, it's just you audition once and then you get cast or you don't. And then on occasion, there's, the whole callback. Especially when I first started out, there was the callback to make sure that I, didn't suck. But this one especially, And the fact that we got to watch video of the show, too, and kind of have, reference the Japanese voices, whereas usually, in auditions, it's just picture of the character, description of the character, and then some lines from the character. So it was really cool to be able to see the character in action and kind of see what we're trying to emulate.
What was it like in the earliest rounds of recording when we had to do it in more than one room with more than one director and had so much going on at the same time?
It definitely forced you to immediately get into it and immediately get into the character.
Yeah! Let's do this!
It didn't give a lot of time for research, so we really had to rely totally on the directors. Because how many directors were there?
Initially, there were three, with me being the main guy, the main charge director. And I started off recording you guys, and I got as much time as possible, which I think was close to a week of just me working on the show, so that I could work with the other directors and this is what we're working on for Chopper, this is what we're working on for Zoro, watch some of this, this is the feel and this is the tone of the show, this is how these characters are to be approached, before we just let everyone have at it. And then even while that was going on, I would go back over their work and cool, you got it. That's a little out of the zone of what Sanji would say. That's a little out of the zone of what Chopper would do, that sort of thing.
Yeah, I imagine that whole process was a lot more difficult for you and the other directors than for the actors. For us, it was just woo, we're working all the time on this awesome show. So it was just really fun, and it gave it sort of a heightened level of importance. It felt like we were working on something really awesome and important in a show that had to get out.
Hurry it up!
All right, I'll do it, but not because you told me to.
So it just felt... It just escalated, all of the emotion and all of the love for the show.
What has been your favorite moment with Chopper so far? Anything stand out in the show, something that resonates with you emotionally?
definitely hands down his origin story. I talked about that for maybe 2 months after recording it. Every time that I would talk about it, I would get really teary-eyed. And it was just so sweet, and it was just cool because, you know, I got to know Chopper before doing his origin story because we went back and recorded that. So, you know, I got to know sort of post whenever he did trust the Straw Hats and when he was already friends with them and when they were already really important in his life. So it was just really cool to see, you know, when he first started out just, you know, kind of hating humans and not really trusting anybody and to see that transformation and to already know where he ended up was just kind of really sweet. And then, I mean, just the whole mushroom and everything is really intense. And
everything
sad.
With Dr. and Dr. Ian.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Yeah. It was so sad and left a really big mark on my heart forever.
Looks like you've been shot. We need to stop the bleeding right away or you're dead. Don't worry. I'll save you.
So far has been your favorite villain in the show, and why?
I think Foxy, because I just think Jonathan Brooks is hilarious. He's the one that makes me laugh the most when I hear him.
Do you remember anything through the Foxy games as far as interaction with Foxy and Chopper that really stuck out for you?
Oh, definitely. Whenever they put the Foxy, glasses,
little mask,
hat,
mask.
Yeah. It's a mask.
Yeah. It's like a mask with a helmet built in, sort of, so it's a weird thing.
Yeah, so when they put the Foxy mask on him, even though I really did love Foxy, but for whatever reason, when they put the Foxy mask on Chopper, I was really upset. It was just wrong and not who Chopper is, and it really upset me a lot. But now you gave me the little figurine, so I have that at my house in a little glass case, him with the mask and everything.
And the dissatisfied look on his face. I recall that now that you say that, because the first couple of lines that we did were where Chopper had the little mask on, you were like, that is just wrong. That's wrong. He should not be wearing that mask. Take that off. You were very upset.
Yeah, it was upsetting. It's the wrong, he's a Straw Hat. He's not a Foxy Pirate.
You guys!
All right, Dr. Chopper, enough of all that. You're one of my crew now. You need to pledge your loyalty to me. And you can start by putting on this mask.
You guys!
So, Chopper doesn't sound too much like Brina just hanging out and talking. What challenges do you face to make Chopper sound the way he does, and what do you have to focus on emotionally to get into character?
As far as just physically, I always have to make sure that, you know, I don't do a lot of screaming the day before or even after. I always try to make sure with One Piece that I only record for, you know, 3 hours max.
2-3 hours.
Yeah, 2-3 hours. And emotionally, what's awesome about Chopper is that he is really funny, and he gets super emotional all the time, but it's still really funny. So for me, I always have to remember, Chopper does not think he's funny. It's not funny to him. It is very emotional. So what makes it funny, though, is the voice. So I just let the voice do the comedy for me, and then I just try to, you know, genuinely connect to whatever emotion he's feeling at the time, because I think that's what ends up making it funnier, and it also gives the character more depth.
So besides Chopper, who is your favorite Straw Hat?
That's a really tough one. But I think I'm going to have to go with Luffy.
Yeah!
Why Luffy?
Because he's so stupid. And he's just so loud. I just love that he's just screaming constantly, even if he's just having a regular conversation.
Yeah!
And any time that he eats is really funny to me. His obsession with food is really funny. And I love, I don't know, I love any kind of interaction that he has with Chopper. But I don't know, but I also really like Usopp, too, because Usopp tends to, we tend to buddy up a lot.
Yeah, right! We won! We won!
I'm so happy!
So I really do like him, too. I like the three of them together. I think they're really cute together. Because they always end up doing something really dumb.
How do you feel that Chopper has grown, like, since Chopper's introduction to where we currently are in the 270s?
The biggest change that he's made from his origin story to now, I think, is the fact that he is so trusting, and he just loves everyone. Like, as soon as he found out there are cool humans in the world and people don't bully me all the time, he just immediately turned into super naive and super like, I trust everyone, even when he probably shouldn't. But I'd say that's his biggest change.
Anything else that you'd like to say to the One Piece fans out there that are watching?
Just that you guys are awesome and I love you, and you're some of the most supportive fans out there, and loyal, and I really appreciate that. And it's a beautiful show and really fun show, and I'm happy that it has such an awesome following.